In this video, I'll show you how to create a new .NET MAUI application and how to add the DevExpress data grid to it. We'll use a Windows PC with Visual Studio 2022 preview installed. After you go through the steps in this tutorial, you'll be able to add DevExpress.NET MAUI controls to your mobile applications. If you're not familiar with the .NET MAUI framework, please review the Microsoft website first. Follow the instructions on how to get started with this platform. You can also review our website to know what components we provide for the .NET MAUI framework. Follow the link in the description below. As of now, we supply the data grid, collection view, charts, scheduler, data form, data editors, tab navigation and pop-up menus, as well as project templates, which I will cover later in this video. Let's run Visual Studio and start without code. First, we want to install DevExpress.NET MAUI project templates. In the Visual Studio main menu, go to Extensions, then Manage Extensions. Type DevExpress into the search box. Find DevExpress.NET MAUI project templates in the search results and click Download. To install the extension, we need to relaunch Visual Studio. Now let's create a new application. In the list of templates, you can now find DevExpress mobile apps. Specify the solution name and location as usual. And when you press Create, the wizard asks you to choose a template for your new application. Following project templates are included. Blank. The project does not contain pre-configured pages. You can create your pages from scratch and customize as needs dictate. Tabbed. The main project page uses tabs to enable navigation between screens. Flyout. The main project page uses a flyout menu to switch between screens. If a non-blank template is selected, the project also contains the sign up, login, about, and other auxiliary pages that can be configured based on business needs and requirements. In this example, we'll be using the blank template. The wizard also allows you to specify the target platforms and components that you plan to use. As of today, our Xamarin and .NET MAUI components are free of charge, but registration is required. Follow this link in the README file. As you can see, our free offer includes the data grid, scheduler, charts, collection view, data form, data editors, and tab view components. Sign in to your DevExpress account or create a new one and reserve your free copy. Once it's done, you can receive your personal key for our NuGet gallery. Follow the second link in the README document. Click Obtain Feed URL and copy your personal key to the clipboard. Now we need to register a new NuGet package source in Visual Studio. In the Solution Explorer, right-click the project. Then click Manage NuGet Packages. In the opened window, click the gear icon at the top right. Add a new package source, name it DevExpress, and paste your personal NuGet feed URL. That's it. You can close the NuGet window and run the application. The first start may take a bit longer. As I've already mentioned, our blank template is a one-screen application that you can start with. Now let's place our data grid control onto this page. In the Solution Explorer, double-click the main page markup file. At the top of the page, you can see that the template declares XAML namespaces for all our controls. Remove the default content and place our data grid instead. Our grid is best for displaying data from a bound data source. It can be a data table, an array of business objects, or any object that implements the iList or iEnumerable interface. The control automatically creates a data column for each field in the bound data source. In the code behind, let's create an employee class that exposes the name, birth date, and on-leave data fields. In the markup, declare a new XAML namespace that targets the application's CLR namespace. This will allow us to use employee objects in the markup. Use the items source property to assign a data source to the grid. Then declare an array and specify the type of object that it will contain. Finally, populate the array with some sample data. Let's run the app again. You can see that the main screen now displays employees in a data grid. All the columns are created automatically, and different data editors are assigned to cells according to the underlying data type. The grid also supports sorting and many other functions out of the box. For example, it supports an advanced layout of columns, grouping, summaries, infinite scrolling, pull to refresh, and much more. These features may require additional customization and settings. In further videos, I'll explain to you in detail all our controls for mobile development, how they work, and how you can customize them. And that's it for this video. If you liked it, give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.